drones or some other way to attain aerial imagery, but those images do not contain the amount of features that we need in order to get an auto mosaic. So when this is the case, how can we use these images or the information contained within these images to still yield a useful result? That is, we need some way to know where the information in the image relates to a position in the world or on the ground. In our case, what we wanted to do was trying to locate earphones just before a harvest of grass and mowing operations. As you can see in here, where you have a big tractor coming along and you have the little deer lying hiding in the grass, and you do not want a situation like this where the mower runs over the little deer form and you may have a young tractor driver having to go out and kill the deer form. So, just to summarize the overall agenda, that is, I'll focus a little bit on our specific case here of discovering the deer forms, just to put it all into context. And then talk a little bit about the information that we require in forms of sensor systems, and summarize a little bit of the results, and then a little bit about what we did to improve the results by making the process semi-automated. So, what we did in order to detect the forms was to take an EE fixed wing drone, fly out at night using a thermal camera, and hopefully the ground and everything around it should be rather cold and the deer is expected to be warm so that we can detect the images. And in the ideal case, you will have something like this. You'll have a set of thermal images like this one, where you can see the earphones and put them into existing software packages, which for Microsoft Photo Stitch or a similar package, and you get a multi-mosaic. Now you can point out the earphones and you know exactly where in the world those earphones were located, and you can go out and do something about them. In the real world, however, what we experienced when doing the project was that quite often in 4 out of 5 cases or something similar to that, our photo mosaics would end up looking something like this. And that was even though that we had an external company that does nothing but flying and recording thermal imagery, which are specialized in the stitching process as well, doing the stitching for us. And still, quite often it was either too windy or similar problems that made the mosaic images fail. So we needed a method where we require no information from within the images themselves in order to geolocate these images. What you can see here is just to follow up on the case is the drone that we used in order to try to remove the deer forms from the field. It's DJI trees on which we mounted an implement which allows us to spray urine from predators, which helps us to, or helps the mother of the deer form when she comes back at night to pick up the deer form because it smells like predator. The problem is that you cannot scare away the deer form itself, as its instinct is just to hide even more in the grass. So, talking about what we need in terms of information, we need some way to know how is the camera oriented in space. In this case, it's our fixed wing drone. And the way we do that is to use a combination of the IMU sensors, inertial measurement units, to figure out the orientation, and then combine that with the GPS and barometric solution in order to determine height and its position in the world. Furthermore, we also need to have some kind of model of how does a given pixel position within the image end up as a position in the real world. That is, we need the lens model for the camera in order to be able to project that single point in space out to somewhere in world space. Beyond that, we also need to, let's say that that point in the camera becomes a vector entering through the lens, as we do not know how far away the object that we're seeing with the camera is located. So we need some way to determine where is that object located. And what we did was to use field terrain modeling, which is simply a model of the height all over the country. In the case of Denmark, this is a model that's publicly available as free data. And it seems to be the case that this is appearing more and more all over Europe with these freely available terrain models. So we're using this model, and we're assuming that the point we're looking for is located somewhere on the ground. And therefore, we can assume that the vector that we're projecting from the probe will end up somewhere on the ground. That is the intersection between the terrain model and the point from the camera. This is what I kind of tried to illustrate here, is that you have the drone in the sky and you know the drone's orientation. Then depending on the image or the position of the pixels within the image, projecting that to the camera model, it could for example just be a simple thin lens model, you'll end up with a vector, and you need to know where that vector hits an object. In our case, as I said, we're assuming that it's the ground that we hit at some point in time by using the terrain model. Doing this, we end up reaching a result that's a bit discouraging, to be quite honest. We took 7 markers out into the area we were photographing. It was 6 silver plate trays, and annotated each of those with RTK GPS, so we knew exactly where the both these were located. In reality though, we ended up with a maximum error, that is the distance from the manually annotated point using the RTK GPS to the projected point of a little more than 42 meters, which is quite a lot, and an average error of 13 meters. So far, it looks like, judging from the data, that was because the drone is, or the drone's IMU system, which is what's estimating the orientation of the drone, combined with the camera, is not in perfect synchronization. But as this is a commercial system and not a system we have developed ourselves, that's a little bit hard to test. So we wanted to go on instead and see how can we fix this or how can we improve on this. So what we did instead was to create a piece of software where when we have our thermal image and we've located our deer here, we want to be able to place that. And either we have a thermal image which is stitched incorrectly so we have absolutely no information, or we can just go and get a normal orthophoto. Doesn't even have to be taken at exactly the same period of time, because the landscape will quite often look a lot alike when you are into this narrow area, and will just simply reproject the corners of the image in there and allow the user manually to correct for any obvious errors in the projection results. And doing that, we were able to in 8 cases to position each of the deer forms with a maximum error of less than 6 meters and a mean error of 3 meters, and thereby get results that was useful in order to solve our case of detecting the deer forms so that we could try to move them away from the field. Thank you.